I decided to give this pocket speech last night, actually. Not decided, but I just started to think about giving it. And later today, during this afternoon, I sent her an email whether she would like me to include me into one of the prepared speakers, which she kindly agreed. Well, what happened last night? Last night I was just surfing through the TV channels. On one of the channels, there was this scene. A guy gets called that he has been seeing, a married guy, he has been seeing a woman for 40 years, and the wife just discovers this. In order to defend himself, the guy says to his wife, during these 40 years, our hands didn't touch each other. So, this is what he said. What he said, this might be true, but this is his excuse to get an excuse from from his wife, so that her wife is convinced that he has not cheated her. Well, I thought, you know, there's something wrong with this. No, there is something wrong. Even if he's right, he is the one who has been cheating his wife. This is cheating, I thought. So I looked up into the dictionary. Cheating is acting dishonestly or unfairly to gain an advantage. Okay, so when I ask you people what comes to your mind first when I say cheating, let's ask John, what comes to your mind? What comes to your mind at first glance when you hear...
It's a lifestyle, actually.
To define cheating, what is cheating?
Okay. This could be is like one can be dishonest, is it like explain.
Yeah, that? But I mean, what kind of an incident comes to your mind when you hear the word
business,
cheating?
It could be,
in business,
yeah.
Okay. Well, I think cheating, when you hear about this word, the first thing comes to your mind is
doping.
Sorry. Doping, yes, maybe doping, but not. This is not the first thing. Don't try to put me in a difficult position. Extramarital relationships, okay, or sexual relationship with, you know, somebody else, out of your wife or your husband.
Is it an allergy?
Sorry.
Is it an allergy?
No, I don't know.
Well. It's nice that this Fatma's cousin or nephew is not here because we can talk, because this is something over 18 years of age, so we can talk freely on this. Unfortunately, it is so. So I just started to discuss with myself why people think of sexual relationship during marriage with some other partner is the only thing that comes to people's mind when they hear about the word cheating. So let's think of students or academicians or scientists. Cheating is, you know, during the examination, looking at your notes or looking at your friend's paper, or plagiarism in academic life, stealing some other people's work and trying to show it as your own work, right? Mm-hmm. Or as Ayhan and John has said, in business, trying to pretend that your product has a better quality than it already has. And finally, we come to marriage. So when we come to marriage and when we are thinking about cheating, why in the world we only think about sexual relationship with other people? So, let's say you get married, your husband looks like this during. Hey, he's a nice guy. Okay. So, okay, there's an unspoken convention. Okay, while marriage, okay, one of the unspoken conventions is I'm not going to go to bed with other people because we are getting married. But is this the only unspoken convention? I think there is more to that. Well, I'm not going to give you any scientific evidences, but I think women are getting married with the expectation that, okay, one day I'm going to shape this guy in a form that I want him to be. On the other hand, guys are getting married thinking that, okay, here's a beautiful lady, I am marrying this lady with the exception, with the expectation that she is going to remain like this all the time, she's not going to be changed. Okay, so this is an unspoken convention, I think, but as the time passes, both sides see that this is not so. The real life is not so. The girl is trying to change the husband, and the husband is as he is always, as he has been. Look at the complaints of the ladies. When talking to their girlfriends, they say, well, this guy, she watches the TV, she watches the football matches all the time, she goes out with his friends to have a beer, he is never, or he's not as much as I want him to be with me. On the other hand, the guys are complaining that when we were getting married, she was a very beautiful girl, and look at her now. She's not taking care of herself as good as she used to do during our fiancé time. Okay? So I'm going to try to tell this to you on the other side. Let's say this guy gets married, and guy becomes like this after a while. So, let's think. Who is cheating now? Who is cheating? When the girl was getting married, this guy, she was at least expecting him to stay like this. But if he becomes this, I think he is, this is my show. I think he is the one who is really cheating in that marriage. So I didn't want to do this, female version of this, because I don't want everybody to hate me. So thanks to Ahmet Yılmaz, this is a caricature of created by Ahmet Yılmaz. As kullanılan, as you know. So, but this is my version of it. I mean, this when before he became kullanılan, he should have been something like this during his younger years, before he got married. So, coming back to what I saw last night, emotional infidelity, or emotional, let's say, cheating. I think this is really what cheating should mean. And this is never being talked, or this is never being discussed among people. Who is seeing whom, and why this woman is seeing the other guy, and she's not telling about this relationship, let's say friendship relationship, to the husband, although their hands do not touch each other. So we have to don't laugh. Assuming that they are telling the truth by saying our hands didn't touch each other. But there is something behind it. If the lady is hesitating to talk about this non-hand touching 20 years long relationship to the husband, there you have the cheat.